My patient has been ordered to have a blood transfusion because she is severely anemic. I have a doctor's order. One of the first things I do is I go in, talk to her, and I verify that she knows that she has the order for a transfusion, her understanding of what a transfusion is, has she ever had a transfusion before, does she have allergies that might cause a problem. I look at her IV line, make sure that it's patent, and so that I can connect. I have already sent a type and cross match down to the laboratory, so that, and she has received her patient ID. When I go down to pick up the blood, and I have 72 hours to use the blood once there's been a type and cross match, I want to verify the doctor's order against the unit, blood type, amount. I'm going to look at the blood to verify that there is nothing in it. I will come back up. I take my patient's vital signs before I I'll set up the saline and the blood. I want to have a baseline. I'm also going to look at lab values so that I know what I've got for hematocrit, hemoglobin, any coagulating factors. I can once again look at the IV line, and then I am ready to put on my, wash my hands, put on my gloves, and I'm going to work with my a second nurse to make sure that we all the paperwork is correct, and we're going to look and independently validate the ID on the patient's badge and the different paperwork. At that point, I will wash my hands, put on gloves, and prepare to hang saline and then the blood. Everything's been clamped, so all the outlets are closed. I'm going to spike my saline. I can actually spike my blood, or I could hang it. Got both of these spiked. I'm going to prime my line. Put the line into a trash can. I will open up the saline on both ends. Open the line here. Prime to go above the top of the filter, making sure I'm getting outlets. I can then now close the saline. I'm going to go to the patient, clean the patient's port, connect the port to the IV, open up the blood, prime it down, and at this point I would make sure that I've set my it to go at 120 milliliters an hour. And I am ready to be coming back and checking on the patient at 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and 15 minutes to make sure that the patient is fine. Okay, so I'm going to infuse the blood for at 120 milliliters an hour for the first hour. And I'm going to check on the patient at 5 minutes, at 10 minutes, and 15 minutes. And then I probably should come and check on the patient further. But I want to make sure that the patient has no adverse reactions to the infusion. After the first hour, I will then increase the infusion rate to whatever the doctor has ordered. Following the completion of the infusion, I would clamp everything, and but let the saline flush the rest of the blood through. If the doctor has ordered a second bag, I would follow the same steps as I did for the first bag. After the blood transfusion is complete, I would make sure that the patient is comfortable, has everything that is needed, has the call light there, and then I would wash my hands and document the everything in terms of blood type, blood flow, and how the patient tolerated the infusion.